Synesthesia is a neurological phenomenon in which two senses are inherently crossed, causing sensations from one sense to lead to an automatic, involuntary experience in another. Listening to music is kind of like watching a live painting that's animated.
My name is Kaitlyn Hova. I'm a violinist, neuroscientist, and computer programmer from Omaha, Nebraska. I designed an open-source 3D printed violin with my husband called the Hovalin that's now printed by people around the world.
Dobbiamo alleggerirlo.
Allora.
Every once in a while, we get an email from somewhere I've never been, and there's my baby, printed out. There's a big indie music scene in Omaha, which is very supportive for these creative ideas and do new different types of music. I feel like the majority of my identity can be attributed to growing up in the Midwest. I owe a lot to public schools. I started out in orchestra class playing violin in fourth grade, and actually at the age of 13, I started performing professionally. My very first job growing up was I was an assistant to a violin maker. I worked for this wonderful man named Glenn Hadsel. He was very giving with families that couldn't necessarily afford to pay full price for a student violin. When I was working in the violin shop, I would have to listen to violins and describe their sound, and colors would be a part of it sometimes. I thought it was normal for years to be able to physically see sounds. Learning about synesthesia in college was a big, mind-blowing moment. I decided to drop my music major and go into neuroscience to figure out how was this happening. Because when you tell people, like, oh, I see sounds, like, that sounds crazy. My husband and I, we wanted to have a synesthesia light show inside of a violin. And what that means is when I play a note, we really wanted to have a violin glow the color that I see. We actually realized that this could solve a lot more problems than just this cool pet project. We were seeing this sad trend of music programs being systematically underfunded, but these same schools are receiving STEM grants. And they have to print something, these 3D printers from the STEM grants. Why not 3D print your music program? I really would love to solve this underfunding problem with music education in public schools because I got so much out of it. And I really want to pay it forward. I'm really big on the phrase, if you can see it, you can become it. And I feel like too often kids are told you have to be one thing. And I think that really closes off all these different opportunities for creative ideas and new things to come into the world. So I choose to put it all out there that I do all these different things and that it is possible. I feel like arts and science inform each other because with the arts, you get the creativity, which allows you to connect the dots with the science, which is the hard facts. Then from that, you learn new things, then you get more creative with them. And in order to feel whole and to feel like all of your creativity and all your curiosity are accessible and can do things, you need to have more than just the arts and more than just the sciences. For some reason, the combination of the two is greater than them separately.